World Cup finals in the Bahamas in April. Whoever won went through, whoever lost didn't. And Portugal won in extra time, 2-1. Portugal getting us underway. They're playing in that fluorescent green strip from left to right on your screens. Leo Martins dispossessed and bursting forward is his twin brother Bernardo, and in the end it's Leo Martins who puts the ball into the back of the net. Just 20 seconds gone and Portugal hit the front. Leo Martins scores. He's a prolific goal scorer. 14 goals for him in the Eurobeach Soccer League in 2017. Portugal's top scorer as they finished runners-up in that tournament. And he's on the board already here. Goodness me, disastrous start for the UAE and a dream start for Portugal. No chance really for Mohamed Al Jazmi in goal for the UAE. And then the two brothers get us underway, Ahmed Bashir and Walid Bashir for the UAE. And what's the decision here? Leo Martins has been penalised. So it's going to be a free kick on the halfway line. And in goal for Portugal, Ellington Andrade. Veteran 11-a-side goalkeeper. But he really was the missing link for Portugal when he started playing beach soccer at the back end of 2014. And he was instrumental in helping the side to a second world title the following year, 2015. 38 years young, the big goalkeeper, and he's up against Walid Bashir. And a good save from Andrade, pushing it round the post. He's been playing his beach soccer recently for the Crystal Club in the Russian Beach Soccer League. Well travelled. Been playing 11-a-side football in the Indian Super League in the recent past. And Ahmed Bashir penalised for that challenge on Bernardo Martins. And the referee, in fact, showing him a yellow card. Just jumping in a little bit, you'd rather fancy. Bernardo Martins making the most of it. So it'll be a free kick to Portugal. Bernardo Martins is the man who will take it. Plays his beach soccer with Sporting Club Braga, the 2017 Portuguese champions. Five of the squad play there. Taking a lengthy run, free kick is just inside the Portugal half. Hoot has gone, so referee just coming over to the bench. Timekeeper making a point to him. Because the free kick's just inside the Portugal half, players are allowed to be goal side of the ball. They have to fan out. Hit low and pushed away by Mohamed Al Jazmi. So a minute gone, and already Portugal a goal to the good. This is a tournament they've not won. They've had enormous success in Europe and on the world stage, but they've not succeeded in securing this title as yet. Is 2017 going to be their year, I wonder? Portugal squad arrived late on Sunday night, early on Monday morning at around 3 a.m. Ahmed Bashir dispossessed. Portugal squad had a 4-day training camp at Rio Maior about 100 kilometres from Lisbon before arriving here in Dubai. It's an interesting looking squad as well, because it doesn't have three of the very experienced players that Mario Narciso could have called upon. Alan Cavalcante, Jose Maria Fonseca, Nuno Belchior, and in the end Bernardo Martins trying to feed Leo Martins, and Leo not quite able to get on the end of it. Yes, three interesting selections there from Portugal, with three veteran players omitted. Opportunity perhaps for Ricardinho, the number 13, Pedro Silva, 14, and Duarte Vivo, number 18, to shine. As Mohamed Al-Jasmi goes down under challenge from Leo Martins. Al-Jasmi, vastly experienced keeper, and a very good one too. So that'll require some treatment. Give us a chance to just talk about the UAE a little bit. Didn't get past the group stages of this year's FIFA Beach Soccer World Cup finals. They've never actually managed that, in fact, the UAE, in all their appearances at Beach Soccer's top table. The end of that tournament, the squad had a one-month break. And subsequent to that, well, preparations have been ongoing for about 2.5 months with the UAE side. Several of the players actually went and played beach soccer in Hungary over the course of the Northern Hemisphere summer. Three of them played for the Energia club, and four of them for Siafok. And they played a couple of warm-up matches ahead of this tournament. They lost to Russia 6-2, and then they beat Paraguay 5-4. Speaking to a member of the coaching staff last night, and they were saying to me, well, the Russia game was the first game the team had played since the World Cup, so they were naturally quite rusty. Got a dedicated facility here in the UAE. There's the national team at Mamza Beach. It's got floodlights as well. It's located on the road between Dubai and Sharjah. Now Jasmine with the free kick, that's off target. In this year's World Cup, the defending champion, having won the tournament in 2015 on home sand. They lost in the quarterfinals to Brazil 4-3, having been in that same group with the UAE. Also Panama and Paraguay were there, but 2017 hasn't been a washout by any stretch of the imagination for Portugal. They were runners-up in the Euro Beach Soccer League. A couple of stage victories for them as well. They topped the regular season standings, and they just had one bad day, actually, in the Euro Beach Soccer League when they lost in the final, the super final match, to Russia 3-1. Otherwise, they were unbeaten throughout the entire European summer. Gives you an indication of their quality. Jordan Santos, good skill. Can't quite match the finish. Another player from Sporting Club Braga, the 2017 Portuguese champions. He's had an exceptional 2017 as well. A couple of the tournaments he's played in Cap Verde and also Siafok in Hungary. He was named as the most valuable player. Portugal's top scorer in this year's FIFA Beach Soccer World Cup as well, with 4 goals. Good save, Al-Jasmi, from his opposite number, Andrade. Wellington Andrade actually scored a goal in the Euro Beach Soccer League this year in Nazaré in Portugal against France. Attempted flick header from Pedro Silva. It'd be good to see what sort of impact he can make in this tournament, the number 14. Headed back across goal by Walid Mohammadi. Walid Bashir. Can't bring that under control. Oh, scorching shot from Bruno Novo. But Ali Karim got the block in. Shot from Ali Karim, one of only four players to have scored in the first six editions of this tournament. The other three, all Russians, Yuri Krasheninnikov, Alexei Makarov and Dmitry Shishin. Abbas Ali, big physical presence, tallest man in the squad at 1.89m. Big number five for the UAE. Jasmi with the shot, fisted away by Andrade. Good strong hands from him. Abbas Ali again. If you're wondering why the music has stopped, call to prayer will take place shortly. Maja, 40 years of age, the veteran, captain for Portugal, man who's won virtually everything there is to win in the game, and a regular here in the UAE, in Dubai, playing his beach soccer. Bursting forward, Ricardinho, good run, very good run indeed. In the end, just crowded out by the UAE, Abbas Ali. Mentioned the UAE went out at the group stage in this year's FIFA Beach Soccer World Cup Finals. Fifth time they'd taken part in the tournament at beach soccer's top table, and the fifth time they'd failed to get past the group stage, but they'll never get any closer to doing so than they did in the Bahamas in April and May. Gosh, it was absolutely heartbreaking from their perspective. They started off by achieving a wonderful victory against Paraguay by 3-2. But then what cost them was a win against Panama, as Andrade makes a good save. Very good stop indeed from Walid Mohammadi. Yes, they beat Panama on penalties, but the way things work in beach soccer, you get 3 points for winning a match in normal time, 2 for winning in extra time, and only 1 for winning on penalties. So failure to beat Panama, who didn't win a game in their group, ultimately proved costly, because when the UAE then lost to Portugal in extra time in the final match of that group, 2-1, that was enough to send Portugal through and the UAE on their way home. UAE, it was heaven and hell for them that last match as well, because Ali Karim actually got an equaliser in the last minute of normal time to take the match to extra time, and the UAE were on a real high then, but then Bruno Novo popped up with the winner. Good save. Very good stop indeed by Al Jasmi. Powerful strike from Ricardinho. And Al Jasmi with the athletics to push it over the top. Keep your tweets coming in, incidentally. Use the hashtag Uawe Intercontinental Cup, all one word. Uawe Intercontinental Cup. Catch up with all the latest action there on that Twitter hashtag. Let us know where you're watching. There's a little bit of a delay, incidentally, as Abbas Ali at the other end of the sand receives some treatment. A little bit of sand in the face, I rather fancy. And that's what the hold-up is for here. Once he's received this treatment, he's going to have to go off the sand, so someone's going to have to come on and replace him. It looks as though it's going to be Ahmed Bashir. Thank you. UAE in this tournament, their best finishes, third place in both 2012 and 2013. But they certainly didn't enjoy much joy in this tournament 12 months ago. Jordan Santos then with a little flick header. Gets the ball back to his goalkeeper. 12 months ago, the UAE had a bit of a nightmare in this tournament, losing 11-1 on the opening day to Brazil, and 7-3 to Tahiti, who incidentally were the side that Portugal beat in the final of the 2015 FIFA Beach Soccer World Cup. UAE lost to Poland on penalties as well, finishing bottom of their group, finished 2-2 after extra time, and they lost 2-0 on penalties. They then lost to Egypt 7-3 before they finally managed to beat the USA 4-3 in their last match to end up 7th out of 8 teams. Free kick to the UAE, and it's going to be taken by Ali Karim. At the veteran stage now, Ali Karim, 37 years of age, 5 goals in this tournament 12 months ago. The UAE's leading scorer. Strikes that one nicely, but off target. Made his debut way back in 2007. Wonderfully skillful player. Just 2 minutes to go then in this first period. And after that opening goal in just 20 seconds, things have been pretty cagey since. Both goalkeepers have made some good stops. Just the one goal to show for the endeavours of the two lineups thus far. Down goes Leo Martins. Was he fouled? But the referee's given a foul to the UAE initially. Yes, the free kick's gone against Leo Martins. Let's see what happened there. That's why it's gone against him. Portugal seemed adamant that they should have got the free kick there, but it wasn't forthcoming for them. So Walid Bashir, the younger of the two Bashir brothers in this UAE lineup, will have the free kick. Got 7 goals in this tournament 2 years ago and was the UAE's top scorer in that edition, the 5th edition of this tournament. He was one of the players who played for Siafok in Hungary past northern summer, and he strikes that well, but just ball slicing off the outside of his right foot and going wide of Ellington Andrade's upright. Ali Mohamed just showed too much of that ball to Jordan Santos. Tough sport, beach soccer. There's no protection for your feet or your ankles or your shins. Bone on bone contact there, and Jordan Santos felt it. Free kick to Portugal, just inside the Portuguese half, so players are allowed to be goal side of the ball. They have to fan out in what's known as that cone between the ball and the opposite corner flags. So a clear line of sight for Jordan Santos up against Mohamed Al-Jasmi. Very long run indeed, a run of about 15 metres. Strikes it well and strikes it in. Al-Jasmi got a solid hand to it, but he couldn't keep it out. Jordan Santos doubles Portugal's lead. It was sheer power in the end from the lanky number 5 that did for Al-Jasmi. Perhaps a little bit slow to get down. Or am I being too critical? He couldn't get enough of a hand on it, could Al-Jasmi. And agonisingly for him and the UAE, He watched the ball creep into the back of the net. Just over a minute to go in this second period. Portugal 2, the UAE 0. A little bit of a cushion then for the Portuguese. What's the UAE's response going to be? Well, the birthday boy, Mohamed Al-Mazmi, talked a good game coming into this tournament. New coach, replacing Guga, that's Gustavo Zlokovic. Said the side's been preparing for this Huawei Intercontinental Cup since July. Following on from their best ever showing in a World Cup. And he said fans of this UAE side can expect to see a team that's organised, skilled and playing with their heart for their country. Well, they might be doing that, but they've got nothing to show for their efforts as yet. All they've done is concede another free kick to Jordan Santos just outside his penalty area. Now, the depth of the penalty area is 9 metres. The length of a big soccer pitch is about 36 metres. So you do the maths. This about 27 metres from Mohamed Al-Jazmi's goal. Drilled in again and a comfortable catch for the little UAE goalkeeper. Just 1.75 metres, Al-Jazmi, only 59 kilos. Ahmed Bashir battling away, dispossessed in the end by Bernardo Martins. Won back by Abdoulhossein Bati. And it's in, yes! Oh, good finish. Ali Mohamed. Ball was bobbling around and almost out of nothing, it seemed. Good work from Bati. And Ali Mohamed in the right place at the right time, just toe-poking the ball home. Ahmed Bashir was involved in the build-up as well. Frustration for Portugal. That ball just looped up off Bruno Torres' attempted block. And Ali Mohamed in the right place at the right time to put the UAE on the scoreboard with just 18 seconds to go. In this first period, Portugal 2, the UAE 1. Well, that'll put a different complexion on the team talks for the two coaches, I'm sure, at the end of the first period. Something for the UAE to clutch onto. For Portugal, a reminder that they're in a contest. Just at the end of that period, there were two balls on the sand, but in the end, all's well that ends well. The hooter goes, and the end of the first 12 minutes of game two on this opening day of the Huawei Beach Soccer Intercontinental Cup 2017. And Portugal lead. Leo Martins after just 20 seconds and Jordan Santos with a free kick from distance. And then right in the last minute of that first period, Ali Mohamed putting the UAE on the board. Portugal 2, the UAE 1. Let's have a look at some highlights from that first 12 minutes. Teams out on the sand and, well, the first highlight was pretty much straight away. First effort from Bernardo Martins was blocked, but the follow-up from his twin brother, Leo Martins, was well and truly buried into the back of the net. Just 20 seconds gone. Bernardo Martins with a free kick, which was saved by Al-Jazmi, and another good stop from Al-Jazmi diving to his right at the other end. There were saves to be made as well by Ellington Andrade. And that was the second goal. Jordan Santos, real power in that free kick. From about the halfway line, high fives all round, a little kiss as well from the reserve goalkeeper Thiago Petroni. And then right at the end of the first period, Ali Mohamed in the right place at the right time to pull a goal back. Portugal 2, the UAE 1. upwards between the UAE players who were on the sand at the start of this second period. They'll know that there's very little to choose between these two teams at the moment. Just a goal in it. Portugal have the advantage. Leo Martins and Jordan Santos the scorers for them. And Ali Mohamed with a goal back for the hosts. It's going to be the UAE in the predominantly red strip getting us underway. Kicking from left to right on your screens. Already we've had 17 goals today in just the second game of the day. Remember, a total of 20 matches to be played over the course of 5 days in this tournament that's second only to the FIFA Beach Soccer World Cup in terms of importance in this sport of beach soccer. The seventh edition of this tournament takes place every year at around this time here in Dubai in the United Arab Emirates. 179 goals were scored 12 months ago. It's not the record, actually, for most goals in a Samsung and indeed Huawei Beach Soccer Intercontinental Cup. The record is actually 185. That was in the third edition in 2013. Oh, and a little flick attempted by Ahmed Bashir. Very nearly found the target. Linton Andrade had to have his wits about him. Here's Ahmed Bashir again. Oh, and the ball just wouldn't sit right for him in the sand in the end. Referee now calling Walid Mohammadi to him. He's obviously seen something he's not happy with off the ball. And he's left it at a strict warning rather than a yellow card. Oh, and that's got to be, is it a red card here for Andrade? He was flicking the ball outside his penalty area. Yes, indeed it is, a red card. Miscontrol from the Portugal goalkeeper. The ball got away from him, it was outside the penalty area. He made the stop with his hands as Ali Karim attempted to flick the ball over Andrade, and the referee having no hesitation there but to send off Andrade. First sending off then of this 2017 Huawei Beach Soccer Intercontinental Cup. And in case you're not sure what that means, what it does mean is that Portugal are down to four players on the sand for the next 2 minutes or until the UAE score. Tactical substitution being made to allow Tiago Petroni, the reserve keeper for Portugal, to come onto the sand. They've just got those four players now out there, and Ali Karim has an absolutely perfect opportunity from just over 9 metres out to bring his side back on level terms. So Tiago Petroni, what pressure on him. His first touch of the ball in this match is to pull it out of the back of the net. Ali Karim scores, it's 2-2. Joy unconfined for the little man. And he becomes the first man to score in all seven editions of this Huawei Beach Soccer Intercontinental Cup. An emphatic finish, absolutely burying the ball into the roof of the net. And the mistake was Andrade's, but Ali Karim taking full advantage. What a good finish that was. 19th goal he scored in the history of this tournament. But a significant one, as I've mentioned, given that it makes him the only man to have scored in all seven editions. In the second minute of the second period, we're all locked up at two apiece. What a great fight back this from the UAE. 2-0 down against the two times world champions. There were bound to be questions, but they've answered those questions thus far very impressively indeed. Bernardo Martins up against Ali Karim. Fisted away by Al Jazmi. And again, a tremendous save from the little man, flying across his goal to his right. He's a wonderful athlete, the goalkeeper from the Al Ahly club. And down goes Ali Karim again. What's been given here now? The UAE players absolutely furious. Oh, another red card! Goodness me! Bernardo Martins gets his marching orders now. Well, I never did. Never seen that in all the years I've been watching beach soccer. Two red cards in such quick succession. You can see from that replay that Bernardo Martins just caught the ankles of Ali Karim. He can't believe it, but he's got to go. The two players sent off for Portugal, literally in the space of seconds. And it's just outside the penalty area once again. The referee obviously deciding that Bernardo Martins robbed Ali Karim of a goal-scoring opportunity there. Mario Narciso, he can't believe the decision. He's going to have to live with it. So once again, Portugal down to four players on the sand. Ali Karim up against Thiago Petroni. Good save from point blank range. That was a top stop. So, four players on the sand for Portugal for 2 minutes or until the UAE score. I mentioned at the very outset that players on both these sides knew each other pretty well. A lot of Portugal players come over here and play their beach soccer in the UAE. It was all smiles before kickoff. No smiles now. There's a lot of tension out on the sand. Decisions have gone against Portugal. They've gone in favour of the UAE. Having said that, on the evidence of what we've seen, you couldn't really argue with either decision, either sending off. What it also means, of course, is that
Thank you. Thank you. We're going to play a game, we're going to give a lot of prizes. We've got a Huawei Bluetooth speaker, we've also got a Huawei Mate 10 lights on. Once again, who wants to join our game later on? We're going to play some games down the pitch, and we're giving it a lot of prizes. All right, I see those three guys raising your hands up. Sit back and relax, I'm going to call you guys fair, okay? Basketball game is 1-21. Portugal coming up next, please welcome back to tennis. Very beautiful, beach soccer dancer. Come on, everybody, put your hands up, it's beautiful ladies right now.
once again, people, come on now. Each soccer dancer. Gracias, chicas. Coming up next is the third and final period for the second match of the evening between Portugal and the UAE. After this game, next match coming up, Russia versus Mexico. Do we get Russian fans in the house? How about Mexican fans? We got someone? Russia! Yeah. four and two goals, four and two.
Thank you.
number three for the UAE. Okay, later on, our next game to pitch, I would need four people. Four. Out of them. I need four people. Anyone, boys, you're up. It's the juggling contest. So, if you can play this game, juggling contest, playing four people. Do the trigger before, raise your hands up. We're gonna play it later. Trigger the next game, okay? For now, if you shoot back the last to turn this game, third and final period, 4-22. Score is 4-3. There you go, ladies and gentlemen, 3-27, we are now tied at 0-4. We are deadlocked. Do we have fans from Portugal? Portuguese fans, make some noise, people. How about the fans of the UAE? Three minutes and 27 left. We are tied at 0-4. What's up, Trish? Are you having a good time, buddy? Yeah. All right, ladies and gentlemen, 1:35 left, and and a score to deadlock at 4 goals in. Once again, I'd like to greet a very happy birthday to the head coach of the UAE national team. Thank you.
Walid Mohammadi. Real stop-start affair this match, but it's not been short on drama. Is there a final sting in the tail, I wonder? Here's Jordan Santos then. Scores! Four for Jordan Santos. Portugal win it. Oh, look at the relief, look at the joy, the ecstasy for Jordan Santos. Wonderful stuff from him. Joy all round on the Portugal bench as well. Oh, exceptional.